Namaste. All of us crave for a disease-free life. Imagine such a beautiful life where you don't get cold or cough or fever or any kind of deformities or pains or injuries or mental stress or tension. Imagine a situation where you don't have to visit hospitals or take any kinds of medicines. How wonderful would it be, right? The antidote to this poison of dreadful diseases is mentioned in Roganutpadaniya Adhyaya of Ashtanga Hridaya Sutrasthana. Before we learn and understand the secrets to a disease-free life, consider subscribing to our channel and like this video. Nityam hitahara vihara sevi samikshyakari visheshvasaktaha data samaha satyaparaha क्षमावान आप्तोपसेवी च भवत्य रोगः. The anvaya of this sloka along with its meaning goes as follows. Nityam hitahara vihara sevi samikshyakari visheshu asaktah data samaha satyaparaha क्षमावान आप्तोपसेवी च अरोगः भवति. A disease free individual is Nityam Hitahara Vihara Sevi, one who always habitually follows and practices a conducive diet and regimen. Samikshakari, one who analyzes a situation before acting or reacting. Such a person thinks about the how, when, what and where to act and also the outcomes of his decisions and actions before acting, thus doing the right thing and avoiding unfavorable actions. Visheshu asaktaha, one who is not attached unnecessarily with the objects of the senses. The vishayas include the sounds, touches, scenes and forms, tastes and smells. Data, one who is charitable or one who sacrifices. Sama, one who considers and accepts all beings as equivalent. Satyaparaha, one who is truthful. Kshamavan, one who forgives the mistakes of others and is not eager to hurt or punish them. Aptopasevi, one who serves and follows aptas and their teachings. Aptas are great souls who simultaneously know about the past, present and the future. Their teachings can be followed without doubt. We learnt about the 8 tenets which are to be followed to lead a disease-free life. It's interesting, right? There's another interesting fact. In Ayurveda, diseases can be classified into 3 kinds based on their etiology. Nija or endogenic, agantu or exogenic, and karmaja, or those due to misdeeds. The 8 tenets that we learn now can be classified to be the antidote for each of these 3 types of diseases. That is, to prevent endogenous diseases, follow the tenets in the first pada or quarter of the sloka. To prevent exogenous diseases, follow the tenets in the second quarter, and to prevent the karmaja diseases, follow the rest of the tenets. This way of sequential narration of details is called Sambhava Tantra Yukti. To learn more about Tantra Yuktis, check out the links in the description box. Let us all lead a disease-free healthy life by following and practicing the teachings of this sloka. For more such content, consider subscribing to our channel, like this video and comment your opinions. Follow us on Instagram and Facebook for more updates.